Welcome to another tying session. I'd like to show you a little caddis pattern that we fish on the Vaal River. It's a very basic fly, also commercially available. It's definitely a beginner's kind of fly. Someone that gets into fly tying and fish yellowfish. We are at the beginning of our yellowfish season on the Vaal River, and this is definitely a fly that works well on the Vaal. But for a beginner, this is definitely something that can be tied and fished without a problem. I'm going to go through the materials as we go along. First, I'm tying it in a size 12 grip, 14731H, which is the heavy wire grip hook. It's a new hook that was launched not too long ago. And it's heavier than the previous heavy wire hook, the normal 14731, which is also still available. I'm tying a piece of grip bag skin in or scat back that I tie in on top of the hook after you thread the hook around the bend, not all the way down, but just sort of past the barb, and make sure that is on top of the hook. And now the caddis is a mustard caddis, tied in obviously a mustard color. And it's a fly that, if you change the color, and I'm going to tie two flies, so if you use exactly the same techniques and the same sequence to tie the green rockworm. So I'm going to show you the green rockworm as well in the same video. So what you do is, once you've tied that bag skin in, you tie in a piece of monofilament. Now I use a 3x or 4x tippet material, and you tie that in on the far side. I tie the rib material always on the side and not on top of the hook, because you want that first wrap to go underneath the abdomen before you wrap over the abdomen. Otherwise it very often slips off the back end, and if you tie a fly with a tail, it pushes the tail out of line. Then the abdomen is tied with grip suede chenille in a cinnamon color, which is like a mustard color, and you'll notice that I leave a gap between the bead and where I start to tie these materials in. And there's a very good reason for that, and that is not to bulk the fly up behind the bead, because we're going to be tying a thorax with dubbing, and you want that space there to work with, otherwise it gets very bulky very quickly. Now what I do at this point, normally when I tie chenilles, I like to use a resin or a varnish or something just to bind it a little bit. And I'm using a resin that doesn't cure or set very quickly. So I need time to make those wraps over the abdomen. So I'll use something that takes a while to dry. I'm not going to fish these flies immediately, so I can put them down and they can dry properly in the next couple of hours. And you wrap that chenille with tight wraps next to each other over the shank, or around the shank all the way to the front, and again remember to leave that gap, and you tie that off at the bottom of the hook shank behind the eye, secure it with two or three wraps of thread, and then cut the chenille away. Make sure you cover that end and pull that in underneath that bead in that countersunk cavity, so you've got a nice clear area to work with. And you're going to fold the buckskin over the shank and secure that right there. two wraps and cut that off. And then we're going to create the rib with a monofilament. We're going to wrap that around the hook, even wraps. I'll make a few wraps to have to create nice segments. That is quite important. And you tie that off underneath the hook as well. Right there. The last step, what we're going to do is we're going to create a dubbing loop and put our dubbing spinner in there. And I'm going to use a grip flashy nymph dubbing for the thorax. Now, there are many different ways of tying a mustard caddis. I've seen guys using just a normal chenille to finish the thorax. I like a little bit of movement in the thorax area. You're going to putting a bit of flashy nymph dubbing in there. It's a coarser dubbing. I use it on the bigger flies. You'll see on the smaller flies, I'm going to tie a small, a size 16 green rockworm, where the materials are the same. There are few changes, but very little. The sequence is the same, but on that I'll be using a normal camel dubbing, a grip camel dubbing. Now, you can, I'll also post a link to the dubbing loop technique so that you can go and check it out and see how it's worked. How it works, we discussed it in a little bit more detail in that video. And you can go and have a look at that. But this is pretty much the finish you get with flashy nymph dubbing, and you tie that off right behind the bead. Right there. And cut that away. And you can tie that off. What I do with this fly, I'll show you now, I just want to tie this off, is to put a, to cut the dubbing at the top a little bit shorter. And that helps just to create a little bit more of a realistic look on the caddis. So I cut that around there, and that is the mustard caddis. There. Now I'm going to change hooks quickly and put a size 16 scud hook in there with the orange bead. Now you can tie this with various in various sizes. You can tie it with tungsten, you can leave the bead out completely, depending on how and where you're going to fish it. It's always a good idea to have some with brass and some with tungsten. I found that the green rockworm with an orange bead is very popular, and especially from looking at commercial fly side, the amount of green rockworms we produce with orange tungsten beads, it's just unreal. And for this I'm going to use a green, insect green, or caddis green rather, scud back. See, I changed the color of the thread and I changed the color of the scud back. Tie that in, and this is pre-cut scud back. You get it in 2.5 millimeter and in 3 millimeter widths. Take that forward. I'm going to tie in a piece of monofilament. There. And again, remember to leave that gap behind the bead. Now, because this is a much smaller fly, I'm going to use a grip micro chenille rather than the suede chenille, which is quite a bit thicker. Simply because I want to create a thinner profile on this fly, because it's smaller. If you use the thicker chenille, it's just not going to look right and you're going to lose a lot of hook gape. Tie that on top. Take the thread forward. Put some resin on there and wrap that chenille around the hook with tight wraps. Now you'll see it immediately leaves a thinner profile that suits this hook a lot better, and it is exactly the same tying sequence, and you've got two different flies that you can fish. Both Gaddis Lava, both very successful yellowfish flies, and you can either tie them in bigger sizes with tungsten to use as a dropper fly, or in smaller sizes with brass like this, or without a bead at all, and use it as a point fly. You can also tie lead in it. It's entirely up to you, very versatile patterns. Just want to get the scut back the right way around. There we go. It's not playing along nicely. There we go. Tie that off in the front. Cut that away. And wrap the monofilament to create the rib. Now, this is probably one of the easiest flies I've ever tied. I think the original Mustard Caddis was developed by Horst Filter, a very good friend of mine who fishes small-scale yellowfish in the East Flowing Rivers around the Swaziland area, Piet Retief area, here in South Africa. And he's probably one of the best guides and fly fishermen in this country. Now the dubbing I'm going to use, I'm also going to use a loop, a dubbing loop. Same technique. I'm going to use olive dubbing, camel dubbing, which is a finer dubbing, but it will suit this fly a lot better. Just make the loop, get the dubbing in there. Again, very little dubbing. You can see the techniques and the bit of a more in detailed discussion on the dubbing loop in the video link below. Put the dubbing twister in there and spin that. You can now grab that with the hackle pliers. And create that buggy thorax behind the bead. And that's it. Cut that away. Tie it off. And trim the top, and there you've got another fly. Two flies, same sequence, very successful, tied in different sizes. Please follow the channel, like the video, and watch out for more of these videos.